discuss little more important terms of this, some basic concepts. So in that, percentage composition. So what is the meaning of the percentage composition? The percentage composition can be calculated by using the formula that number of parts by mass of the element divided by molecular mass of the compound into 100. So how much, which compounds percentage we need to calculate, or which elements percentage we need to calculate, that elements mass you have to take and divided by the total molecular mass of that whole compound, total molecular mass of that whole compound into 100. So let us take one example. Here they have given CH4, that is methane. I need to calculate the percentage of the carbon and percentage of the hydrogen in this. Okay, only two elements are there, carbon and hydrogen. So I need to know how much percentage of the carbon is present here and how much percentage of the hydrogen is present here. So let us find out the molecular formula of this compound, that is the molecular mass of this compound, not formula. Formula they have given, the atomic mass of the carbon, the atomic mass of the hydrogen. So as there are four hydrogens, I am going to take it as totally it will be around 60. Okay. I need to calculate the percentage of the carbon according to the formula. First, the mass of the element. So what is the mass of the element here? It is the mass of the carbon is 12 divided by total mass of the compound, that is the total molecular mass of the compound is 16 into 100. As we are calculating the percentage, it will be around 75%. Okay. So the mass of that element divided by total mass of the whole compound into 100. Clear? So next, I need to calculate the percentage of the hydrogen. As there are four hydrogens are there, 4 divided by 16, and the molecular mass is same in both the cases, 16 into 100, it will be at around 25%. So totally when we add these two, you are going to get 100%, because we are calculating the percent. Percent means that is up to the 100 itself. So this is how we can able to calculate the percentage of the carbon and hydrogen in a given methane. Similarly, even you can calculate the percentage of the calcium carbonate. The percentage of the calcium you can able to calculate, and the percentage of the carbon, percentage of the oxygen. How this can be calculated? First, to find out the molecular mass of this compound, and then divide the atomic mass of each element to the by the molecular mass into 100. Okay, so like this you can able to calculate the percentage of that element. Next, empirical and molecular formula. Here the empirical formula shows the simplest ratio of the elements. It means the ratio it will going to tell, it will not going to exactly what is the formula, only it will tells the idea of the simplest ratio of the elements, while the molecular formula gives the actual number of the atoms present in it, the actually how many atoms are present in it, that is, that idea is given by the molecular formula, while only the ratio of the elements can be given by the empirical formula. Clear? So then how it can be taken? Let me take one example, glucose. So glucose, here the molecular formula of the glucose is C6H12O6, as we know, C6H12O6. So when I come to the, this is the molecular formula of the glucose. Suppose I need to know the empirical formula. So empirical formula is the simplest ratio of the atoms present or elements present in it. So ratio means, if I look at the ratio, means it will be CH2O. Okay, why 6, 6? It means 1. C is, that is carbon is 1, oxygen is 1, and hydrogens are a double, it will be at around H2. So the empirical formula of the glucose is CH2O. Okay, while the molecular formula of the glucose is C6H12O6. So this shows the ratio, the simplest ratio of the elements in it. For example, that is 1:2:1. 1 carbon, 2 hydrogen, 1 oxygen. This will shows, that is empirical formula shows the simplest ratio, while the molecular formula shows the actual number of the these atoms present in it. Clear? So let us go for the one more example, hydrogen peroxide. The molecular formula of the hydrogen peroxide is H2O2. The molecular formula of the hydrogen peroxide is H2O2. So if I go for the simplest ratio of the hydrogen and oxygen, it will be, that is 2:2, which is nothing but 1:1. So the formula is HO. So the formula, empirical formula of the hydrogen peroxide is HO, not H2O2. H2O2, it indicates the molecular formula, while HO indicates the empirical formula. Clear? So next we will go for the, there is a one interrelationship between the molecular and empirical formula. Molecular formula is equals to N into empirical formula. As you know, while solving the problems, we can able to use this one, and where N can be calculated by using the formula molar mass divided by empirical mass, we can able to find out the N. So while solving our problems, I will explain you how it can be calculated. So see here, first one is percentage composition. How it is calculated? The mass of that element divided by total mass of the compound into 100. And then empirical formula shows the simplest ratio of the elements present in it, while the molecular formula shows the actual number of the atoms present in it. And what is the interrelationship between the molecular formula and empirical formula? Molecular formula is equals to N into empirical formula, where N is the molar mass divided by empirical mass. Clear? So next we will go for the certain terms. Concentration terms we are telling. Of concentration is nothing but the amount of the solute present in the given solution, we can say. Suppose, let me take one solvent and I am adding solute to it. So the how much amount of the solute is present in it, that is nothing but its concentration. So we can use here only two terms. One is dilute and one more is concentrated. Dilute means solute is less, solvent is more. While concentrated means solute is more while the solvent is less. But these terms cannot be used properly, so we are going to use certain terms, very important terms for the concentration. The first one is mass percentage of the component. So how it can be calculated, the mass percentage of the component, by using the formula that mass of the solute divided by total mass of the solution into 100. So this is the formula of the mass percentage of the component. Clear? The mass of the solute, you are going to take solute here. The mass of the solute divided by total mass of the solution means here you have to add the mass of the solute plus mass of solvent, because we are telling solution. Solution is always the combination of the solute and solvent. So you need to take here that is the mass of solution as the mass of the solute plus mass of the solvent. Clear? So next, parts per million, it is also one of the term which is used for the expression of the concentration. And here the mass of the solute divided by mass of the solution into 10^6. Why we are using the 10^6? Because it is parts per million. Million means 10^6, and this concentration term can be used when the solute is present in trace quantity. When the solute is present in trace quantity, it means less quantity solute is present, means we can use the term ppm, that is parts per million. Why I am multiplying with the help by taking the 10^6? Because it is million. Clear? So next, mole fraction. Mole fraction is indicated by the X. Mole fraction is indicated by the X. Okay. Suppose I am going to add the solute and I am going to mix that solute with the solvent, and there is a formation of the solution. So let me take I want to calculate the mole fraction of the solute. Then how that can be calculated? Here, mole fraction of the solute is equals to number of moles of the solute. You have to take the number of moles of the solute divided by total number of the all the components. So see here, solution consisting of only two components. One component is solute and one more component is solvent. So the total number of moles of the all the component means that is the number of moles of the solute plus the number of moles of the solvent. So the mole fraction is, let me take generally if I have a component, so the mole fraction of the that A component will be Na divided by Na plus Nb. Similarly, if I go for the mole fraction of the solvent means, so what happens? Mole fraction of solvent, this is, I want to calculate the mole fraction of the solvent means number of moles of solvent divided by number of moles of solute plus number of moles of solvent. So this is how we can able to find the mole fraction of the components. Next, molarity. So molarity is indicated by the capital M. Molarity is indicated by the capital M here. It can be calculated by using the formula that, or it can be defined as, it is the ratio of the number of moles of the solute divided by volume of the solution should be taken in liter. So how many number of moles of the solute are dissolved in volume of the solution, that volume must be in liter. Okay, so the molarity, capital M is equal to number of moles of the solute divided by volume of the solution is taken in terms of liter. Next, molality. Molality is indicated by the small m. Molality is indicated by the small m. While solving the problem, you must be concentrate of, that means you must be aware of these two terms. Suppose if they have asked 0.1 m, this m means that is the molarity. Suppose if they have asked like this 0.99 m, this is the molal solution, 0.99 molal solution. So whatever the term they have given, that you must be aware of it. Okay, so the molality is similar to molarity, but the difference is that the denominator part is different. Here also the number of moles of the solute divided by mass of the solvent taken in terms of kg. The mass of the solvent is taken in kg. So that is what we called as molality. And the one more term is there, normality. Normality is written, that is indicated by the capital N. The normality is equals to the number of gram equivalent of the solute divided by volume of the solution is taken in liter. Here volume of the solution in terms of molarity and normality, the volume of the solution is taken in terms of liter. But here the number of gram equivalent of the solute is taken, here number of moles of the solute is taken. So this is how we can explain regarding the concentration of the, how to measure the concentration by using the different terms. So first one is mass percentage, and here mass of the solute divided by mass of the solvent into 100. As we are telling, percentage multiplied by the 100, and then next parts per million, that is shortly written as ppm, and here the mass of the solute divided by mass of the solution into 10 to the power 6. The 10 to the power 6 is the million, it indicates the million. And then mole fraction is indicated by the x. Suppose I need to calculate the mole fraction of the any component, that is equals to number of moles of that component divided by number of moles of all the components present in the solution. Okay, next, molarity is indicated by the capital M. It is equals to number of moles of the solute divided by volume of the solution taken in liter. And then molality means number of moles of the solute divided by mass of the solvent is taken in kg. And finally, normality is equals to number of gram equivalent of the solute divided by volume of the solution is taken in terms of liter. Okay, so in our next video, we are going to discuss certain problems based on these concepts. Okay, thank you. Let's go for the one example. Here, the mole fraction of the solute in a 1.00 m aqueous solution is. So the question is that you need to calculate mole fraction. So what they have given, 1 molal, small m means molal, small m means molality, okay, molal aqueous solution, clear, and the mole fraction of the solute they have asked, okay. So here, as they are telling 1.00 molal, so already I said you the molality is the number of moles of the solute divided by mass of the solvent is taken in kg. It means the number of moles of the solute is 1. And see here, aqueous solution, it consisting of the only two component, one is solute and one more is solvent. Okay, one is solute and one more is solvent. So I need to calculate the mole fraction of the solute. The mole fraction of the solute is equal to number of moles of solute divided by total number of all the components. So which are the all components? Here only two components are there. So I will take number of moles of solute plus number of moles of solvent. Okay, so number of moles of solutes are directly given, as it is 1.00 molal aqueous solution, means the number of moles of solute will be 1, clear, 1, and here also it will be 1 plus. Now I need to calculate a number of moles of the solvent. What is the solvent? Solvent is nothing but water. So water means we are taking water as a solvent. In order to find out a number of moles, mass divided by molar mass, mass divided by molar mass, as again it is molality, again it is a molality term they have given, means here what we are going to take number of moles, number of molality, small m is equal to number of moles of solute divided by mass of solvent in kg, mass of solvent in kg. Kg means 1000 grams, okay. So I will take here mass as 1000 divided by molar mass of the water is 18, okay. And if I calculate, this will be at around 55.55. See here, I need to calculate number of moles of the solute and number of moles of the solvent in order to find out the mole fraction of solute. So the number of moles of the solute is directly given, that is molal solution. And here, in order to calculate the number of moles of the water, I need to know the mass. Molar mass, we know that is 18. Okay, mass, how it is again calculated according to your given question. As it is given molal, so here it will be in terms of kg, so 1000 divided by 18, it will be around 55.55, and if I take like this, and if you simplified this, you are going to get option B as a answer. I hope so you are getting. See here, mole fraction of the solute in a 1.00 m aqueous solution. So mole fraction I need to calculate. So mole fraction, before that they have given one hint that 1.00 molal aqueous solution. Okay, it means 1, that is the number of moles of the solute is 1, and where it is dissolved in kg of the solvent is water. So x solute is equals to n of solute, that is number of moles of solute divided by number of moles of solute plus number of moles of the solvent. And then if I, this is directly given, I have take 1 and 1, and this I need to calculate it again. Here the number of moles will be mass divided by molar mass. Okay, and here the mass is again calculated with the help of this molal solution. Here in terms of kg means you have to take 1000. 1000 divided by 18, it will be around 55.55. So when I substituted all these values in the formula and I simplified this, you are going to get 0.0177 as a answer. So this is the mole fraction. Okay, let's go for the second. an empirical formula of a compound of the molecular mass 120 is CH2O. The molecular formula of the compound. See here what they have given, let me write. An empirical formula of the compound of a molecular mass. It means they have provided a molecular mass is equals to 120, and empirical formula also they have given. Empirical formula. What is the empirical formula? CH2O. Okay. Now I need to calculate empirical formula mass. That is empirical formula mass. So carbon 12 plus 2 plus 16, it will be around 30. Okay. So what I want to calculate? Molecular formula. Molecular formula, what is the molecular formula? Molecular formula is equals to n into empirical formula. Okay. Now I don't know n. So how to calculate n? N is equals to molecular mass divided by empirical formula mass. So both we know, this is molecular mass is 120 divided by empirical mass we have calculated, it will be around 4. Okay. Now I want to calculate molecular formula. Is equals to, what is the empirical formula? CH2O into N. It means 4C4H8O4. So option A is the correct. So see here, they have given the molecular mass 120. And they have given the empirical formula CH2O. I need to calculate the molecular formula. So molecular formula I need to calculate. So let me calculate first the empirical formula mass. Empirical formula mass is 12 plus, that is CH2O is there. Empirical formula they have given. And if I calculate the mass, means it will be around 30. So now I need to calculate molecular formula. Molecular formula is equals to n into empirical formula, but I don't know what is the value of n. So how the value of n is taken? Molecular mass divided by empirical mass. Okay. And the molecular mass is 120, and this empirical mass which we calculated, that is 30, and when you divide these two, you are going to get 4 as your answer. Again, I substitute the value of n in the above formula. Molecular formula is equals to empirical formula into n. Okay. And here the empirical formula is CH2O, and thus I am going to substitute the value of n as a 4, and you multiply this, means so finally you are going to get C4H8O4 as a molecular formula. So in the given option, A is the correct option. Okay. So like this we are going to solve few more examples in our next class. Thank you.